Hi there, and welcome to another episode about WordPress and Elementor. My name is Robert, and in this video, I will show you how to optimize images on your WordPress website with Optimole, especially when using the Elementor page builder. Optimole might look like your garden variety image optimizer for WordPress. So if you are already using Smush or Imagify, you would probably ignore it completely. There are, however, a few differences that make Optimole stand out. It is fully compatible with Elementor. This means that instead of optimizing just what's in your media library, it also works with every image that's processed via Elementor. This includes backgrounds, plus anything else that's in the custom CSS that Elementor outputs. The optimization happens in the cloud, which means that Optimole doesn't alter anything in your media library. You get to keep your original images intact. On top of that, you can also lazy load images without jQuery, which is excellent for performance. This lazy loading mechanism works not only within HTML images, but also with backgrounds handled through CSS. You can also optimize GIFs by converting them to video files like MP4 and WebM. Videos are smaller than animated GIFs in most cases. Another great feature is that it will check the visitor's device and browser, and always delivers an image that's tailor optimized for them. This also works for visitors with slow internet connections. It will downgrade the image quality accordingly when needed. On the other hand, if the visitor's browser supports them, Optimole serves Retina and WebP images. Also, you can set exclusions, for example, to not optimize images based on image extensions, names, or whole page URLs. Last but not least, you can watermark your images for improved security, if you've had your images stolen by other sites. Optimole also has the whole package of must-have features among image optimizers. I'm talking about things like compression level controls, lossy and lossless optimization, tracking and monitoring your compression stats, and a full autopilot mode. The installation process of Optimole is the same as with any other WordPress plugin. You can get it either from optimole.com/wordpress or just install it directly from your WordPress dashboard in plugins, where you can search for it like so. After activating the plugin, you will be asked to register for an API key. Since Optimole processes your images in the cloud, the API key is how you authenticate your site with the main Optimole service. As you can see on the screen, you get to show your optimized images to up to 5,000 visitors a month for free. You'll get your API key via email, then you just need to copy and paste it into the activation box. After that, you'll see the main Optimole panel. At this stage, Optimole is already set to work on autopilot on most WordPress sites. However, you might still want to take a look at the Settings tab to make a few tweaks and customize your needs perfectly. You should enable image replacement. This one needs to stay enabled if you want Optimole to do its job. Scale images and lazy load is where you turn on one of Optimole's most useful features, serving optimized images based on the visitor's viewport and device. Leave it enabled for best results. For additional settings, switch the tab from General to Advanced. You'll find a couple of subtabs there offering the following settings. Enable network-based optimizations. Enable it when you want to serve more heavily optimized images for visitors on slow internet connections. Enable GIF to video conversion. Very useful if you like to publish a lot of animated GIFs. Enable Retina images, This one makes sure that your images look good on all screens, even the big ones. Enable lazy load for background images. The name says it all. This is one of the unique features of Optimole, perfect for pages created with Elementor. Exclusions are for those of you who don't want to optimize certain types of images, specific image files, or images on particular pages within your site. Then you can exclude them here. So cool, right? Compression level. This is where the fun starts. Let's discuss this one in a bit more detail. Optimole comes with three settings for the compression level. Depending on your site and the types of images you publish, some of these settings might be better for you than others. I'd recommend switching to the low, medium, and high settings to see what the impact is on your images. Optimole offers a quick preview as you toggle through these settings. If you use a lot of photographs on your site, you can set this to high. For more nuanced and detail-heavy images, the medium setting might be better. Here's how to make sure that Optimole works with your Elementor-powered site correctly. If you have Elementor already enabled on the site, you'll see this notice in the Possible Issues tab. What you need to do is to go to Elementor, Tools, on your dashboard and in the General tab, click Regenerate Files. Among other things, this will replace Elementor's standard image paths with those going through Optimole. With that done, Optimole is fully enabled to work with Elementor. For the purpose of this video, I've built myself a landing page in Elementor. As you can see, there's a handful of images there. Specifically, the image in the center, the background image of the big title section, another background image behind this section, and the logos over here. We can ignore the social media icons as well as all other icons on the page. Those are very different types of images from the perspective of an image optimization plugin. All we have to do to ensure that Optimole is doing its job correctly is to view the source of the page and see the path of your images. To do that, push F12 on your keyboard or right-click and inspect your page. You should see something like this when checking the path of your images. You'll see that all images listed above have been replaced with Optimole origin URLs. So those are on-page images, but what about the backgrounds? Since the CSS for that is generated on Elementor's end, we need to fire up Chrome Developer Tools to investigate. Once you find the block with the background and view its CSS, you can see that the image has been replaced as well. With that, you can now be confident that Optimole has been integrated with your Elementor-powered website correctly. On the front end, of course, it's business as usual. All your images should look just as good as ever.